family stability and love, both at home and in the public square. You can be better informed, more motivated, and more effective. Subscribe to our fact-filled newsletter, follow us on Facebook, check out our YouTube channel, listen to our podcasts, and keep up to date with all of our projects at ruthinstitute.org. Dr. J is once again a guest of Father Rob Jack on Sacred Heart Radio's Driving Home the Faith. On this eve of Mother's Day weekend, they're discussing motherhood.
With us now is Dr. Jennifer Roback Morris, and she is the head of the Ruth Institute, an interfaith nonprofit organization helping defend the family and repair the damage of the sexual revolution. Her most recent book is The Sexual State: How Elite Ideologies Are Destroying Lives. Thank you for being with us today, Dr. Morris.
I'm glad to be with you. It sounds great. I wish I had one of those Sacred Heart magnets. Or, of course, I don't know what people would do with it in Louisiana, but that's okay. I wish I had one. Sounds great.
Well, I'll tell you what. We'll get you one. Send us your address, and we'll send you one out right away.
Sounds good. You know, I'm noticing we have quite a fan base in Cincinnati now. The Ruth Institute does. You know, we're getting cards and donations and emails and things from people in Cincinnati. So somebody's listening, Father.
Well, that's great.
What I'm guessing.
That's great. You know, I remember that song from 1776, Is Anybody There? Does Anybody Care?
Yeah.
I'm not John Adams, but you know, you sit here and you wonder sometimes. But this coming week, Sunday is Mother's Day, a very important day for, you know, mothers, but especially for children, whether the mothers are still alive or they're no longer with us. To honor our mothers is a very important part of our life, gratitude.
That's right. That's right. And, you know, we just opened a Motherhood Resource Center at the Ruth Institute talking about the importance of mothers, you know, and all that mothers actually do in the development of a child, how important mothers are for the development of your personality and really for the stability of society. You know, if mom's not there, it's tough. And the stability of the union of the mother and father is very important. And, you know, mothers are really, in a sense, irreplaceable. And so we're very excited about the Motherhood Resource Center with lots of combination of research, first-person stories, and various media and interviews type material on that resource center.
You know, one of the things, and there's no manual for how to be a mother. You know, when you have a child, they don't hand you this big book and say, okay, start at page one and call me when you're done. And there's no manual for this. But usually what, of course, has helped is that having mothers and grandmothers, great-grandmothers, aunts and uncles, other women who have learned that. But our society today, especially with the broken families, both, you know, Caucasian and African-American communities especially, they don't have mother role models to see sometimes.
You know, that's very often the case. And that is one of the great tragedies of the sexual revolution, is the way the mother-child bond has actually been attacked, you know. I mean, if you think about all the rhetoric around abortion and the so-called right to choose and all of that, you know, we've all been told that unless we can control our fertility perfectly, we can't be equal, we can't be full parties in society, and that our well-being as women absolutely depends on the right to kill our baby whenever we feel like it. Well, you know what? That is certainly an attack on the mother-child bond, right? Because there's nothing more powerful than the attachment between a mother and a child. There's no relationship more intimate when it gets down to it, you know? One person's actually inside the other, you know?
That's
and,
right.
So to attack that bond, you know, wow, there's so much fallout of so many different types from that. You can hardly think it through, you know what I mean? It's like one thing after another. It's like, I'm a good person because I got a PhD. I'm a good person because I got a promotion. And wait, I'm 40 and I wish I had a kid and I'm not even married. Wait, what? What am I supposed to do now? You know, I mean, there's just so many spinoffs from this, from these ideologies that to just pause here on Mother's Day and be appreciative of this wonderful relationship that God has given us. You know, the capacity that women have to bring new life into being, to cooperate with God and in an act of love with our husbands to bring forth new life. It's a beautiful and amazing and wonderful thing. And I think it shows what the Catholic Church has always taught, which is that the human person is meant for love. And without love, our lives don't make sense. You know, if something happens to that mother-child bond, it can be catastrophic for kids. And it's catastrophic for the mom to lose her child, right? So I think it's really important to pause and go deeper than the Hallmark greeting card and flowers and roses and chocolates approach to Mother's Day, you know, and just really ponder what God has done in creating this way of the species carrying on, you know, mothers and fathers loving each other, bringing forth a child as the fruit of their love, the embodiment of their love, and that carrying forward throughout the whole life. That's what it means to be human, is to be love and be loved.
You know, one person I know said, you know why it's important to have a mother? Because God wanted to have a mother. I mean, he did. God was incarnate in Jesus Christ, and he chose Mary to be his mother. So, if God wants to have a mother, you know, they must be pretty important.
That's right. I mean, he planned the whole thing from the beginning, okay? He didn't have to do it this way, right?
That's right.
he didn't have to have sexual reproduction. He didn't have to have male and female, but this is what God wanted, And as St. John Paul the Great has taught us, you know, in the theology of the body, God is revealing to us something about himself by making us male and female, and the way that we interact as men and women, and the way that new life comes into being. All of that is a kind of revelation by God of himself to us, you know. So Mother's Day is a great day to go deeper and deeper into these amazing mysteries that we can shed some light on this as Catholics. You know, there's more going on than basic biology. The biology is important, and we seem to not even like the biology anymore. But there's so many deep layers to this relationship between mother and child.
Well, and unfortunately, you know, Dr. Morris, one of the big problems we're facing today, I believe it was in the statistics yesterday that the birth rate in this country is the lowest it has been in many, many years. Because parents, I mean, men and women are not having children. They've been told that they're a burden or they're an accessory, but they're not necessary for family life. And, you know, we can't get away from Scripture. God said, be fruitful and multiply. And, It is amazing thing that if human beings created in God's image and likeness have become so self-centered that they don't even want to share enough of themselves that with a person of the opposite sex who they're married to bring a new life in the world. I always thought that was a great privilege to have, but you know, they don't see it. Many don't see it that way today.
Yes. Well, you know, it is a great privilege, the opportunity to give life, to create new life. And it's one of our joys as women, you know. And when you think about the thing that is called feminism and that claims to speak for all women, the way it has denigrated motherhood, you know, so many branches of feminism attack motherhood and, you know, treat it as something that's that holds women back and so on. The amount of propaganda we've been subjected to is really astonishing when you think about it. You know, you and I have talked about this before,
sure,
the amount of propaganda that this society is full of. But when you get right down to it, if you're going to disrupt the mother-child bond, you got to really pump a lot of propaganda into that to do that. You know?
Well, we have just bucketful. We've had fire hoses full,
that's
Dr.
Right.
Morrison.
That's really
what we're facing right now is this terrible, this tragedy of this, and you know, the fight back. You know, there is an old saying in newspapers: don't pick a fight with someone who buys ink by the barrel. Well, you know, we gotta. I mean, because unfortunately, our fight is against the culture, the media, the government, and you know, we're used to being outnumbered in fights. But boy, we need to recover that zeal, and we as Catholics. I think, unfortunately, we've taken on much of these modern ideas of not having as many children, and it's a shame.
Yes, that's very true. But, you know, when you look back over the history of the Church, Father, and as Catholics, I think we have an obligation to look back at our history. There have been many periods in history where there have been terrible errors in society. You know, you think back to the early church and the Arian crisis where they couldn't figure out whether Jesus was God or man or whatever, you know, and now, of course, everybody should know Jesus Christ is true God and true man. But it took the church a while to figure that out. And we figured it out because of the heresy. You know, they were forced to think it through. So today, we're being forced to think through motherhood, fatherhood, the human body, our sexual nature, the gendered nature of the body. We're forced to think through all of that in a way that, you know, people growing up, when we were, you and I were growing up in the 50s, nobody had to think about it. We were on autopilot. We took it all for granted. Well, by the time this is all done, you know, in 100 years or so, we'll have this, you know, we will, if we do our work, Father, if we do what we're supposed to be doing, the future generations will have a much clearer understanding of what it means to be a man and what it means to be a woman and why we need mothers and why we need fathers and why we need stable marriages, you know, and the beauty of being a parent, you know, and just how wonderful it is to share your life with a child and to bring new life into being, you know. That's the possibility, and that's what we have to hold out for ourselves, regardless of our opponents who buy ink by the barrel and who control all the electrons out there and all the electronic media. You know, we must persevere.
Dr. Morse, thank you for being with us today and sharing this important Motherhood Resource Center at the Ruth Institute. If people want to find out more about the Ruth Institute, where can they go?
You can go to our Ruth Institute Facebook page, where we have a number of wonderful little posts and things to talk about on Mother's Day. And then you can find the Ruth Institute Resource Center at ruthinstitute.org. That's ruthinstitute.org.
Well, thank you very much, Dr. Morse. I hope you have a wonderful day.
Thanks very much.
You've just been listening to Dr. J and Father Rob Jack discussing motherhood and more in this segment of Sacred Heart Radio's Driving Home the Faith. Check out our newest resource center on motherhood over at ruthinstitute.org. The Ruth Institute is a nonprofit educational organization equipping effective advocates for family stability and love, both at home and in the public square. Our podcasts can be found online at ruthinstitute.org and iTunes. And as always, they're under a Creative Commons license. If you've enjoyed them, please share them with friends. Like us on Facebook, check out the site, and subscribe to our weekly newsletter to stay informed.